So if your pairing is unsuccessful, there's two ways that you can tell. It's either gonna go right back into the pairing mode, as you see here, with the light scrolling from the bottom to the top, or it's going to have a steady, solid action light, and it's not gonna go to the solid green sensor light. So if you have either of those, there's two videos that I'm gonna follow up with on this one on how to resolve that issue and make sure that you get a complete and successful pairing. All right, guys, so if you guys ever experience this where you take the sensor off of the magnet in the pool, engaging it into the pairing process, and it, you end up with a solid action light, this is indicating that they're communicating, but they're not communicating successfully, and that you wanna maybe change the location of your antenna. You might put it a few feet that way, a few feet this way, maybe utilize the antenna extension and put it in a better spot. And what that's gonna do, it's going to allow you to maybe have better communication. So to get it out of this mode, if you're not getting the sensor light after 2.5 minutes, or you're not getting flashes every 4 seconds here, go ahead and unplug it. We're gonna reset the unit by unplugging it and plugging it back in. So we're just gonna unplug it for 5 or 10 seconds here, let the lights go off, give it a couple seconds, and then we're gonna plug it back in, and it's gonna be right into the pairing mode. So it's gonna be right where we want it to be, and you're gonna go back to the sensor in the pool, and you're gonna engage it back into the pairing process with the antenna in a new position so that we can hopefully have a successful pairing.